How's it going, everybody? So I told you before that I will be showing you how I create these transparent transitions and transparent effects that I'm using on stream and with MixPlay. And it's pretty much the same process for transitions and effects. I'm using two free softwares, Davinci Resolve, the free version of Davinci Resolve, which is amazing on its own. And I'm also using an open source software called XMedia Recode, which I will be using to convert a transparent MOV file into a transparent WebM file. And the reason for that is because OBS seems to handle transparent WebM files way better than MOV files. So without further ado, let's get to Davinci Resolve. So once you start Davinci Resolve and create a new project, you can go ahead and import your media. And right here I have the left side of a door and the right side of a door. And what I will basically do is a simple transition where the door starts open, it closes, and then it opens again. And the change from scene A to scene B happens when the doors are closed. So because this isn't an editing tutorial, I'll just fast forward this part and I will come back when it's time to render the video. Okay, here we go. I just created this simple animation where the door closes and then it opens again. And what I will do right now is select everything in the timeline, right click, and create a new compound clip. I'm just gonna go with the default name. And the reason I'm doing this is because I can only render individual transparent videos. And so by creating compound, this will count as one clip. Now to render the video, click on deliver. And here is basically where the magic happens. Just make sure you have the correct settings so you can export a transparent video with an alpha channel. So click on individual clips. When it comes to format, choose QuickTime. For codec, choose GoPro Cineform. And for type, choose RGB. Choose the resolution that you want and just make sure that you're choosing export alpha. Once you're done, click on add to render queue and then start render. Now once you have your video, start XMedia Recode, add your transition or video, choose your video, and because we don't have sound in this video, I'm just going to go with video only, choose WebM for format, and then go to video, and make sure that you have codec set to VP9, because VP8 does not support transparent videos. You can leave the rest of the settings as it is, but I usually choose the best quality. Choose the destination for your video, add to queue, and then click on encode. Now this could take a couple of minutes here. Once the video is done, you can click OK and start OBS Studio. Now in OBS Studio, under scene transitions, add a new transition, click on stinger, call it whatever you want. We're just gonna go with door animation here, and then choose your WebM video. You can change the transition point to frame. You can preview your transition, and as you can see, it does not fit well. So we're going to change this to 85. Preview the transition, and that's perfect. And as you can see, if I change between these, it works perfectly. The reason you need to change these MOV videos to WebM is because if you're using the MixItUp bot, for example, and you want to have some MixPlay effects, you can only choose transparent WebM videos. You cannot choose MOV files, unlike OBS, where you have the luxury of choosing between a transparent MOV file or a transparent WebM file. Usually the transparent WebM files work much better than MOV files on OBS, so that's why I'm using WebM here. That's basically it. I hope I was able to show you the process and I hope you learned something from this video. If you have any questions, please put them in the comments below, or you can join us on our Discord server where we can help you one-on-one in case you need some help. I will also include a link to this transition in case you want to download it and use it for your stream. The link will be in the description. As always, stay awesome. Peace.